Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. Let's move out, people.
All right, big guy.
We've kind of made ourselves some new friends.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Bottle cap. Gold watch is probably worthwhile. Ammo. Let's see. I'm not doing great on capacity, so I don't want to grab absolutely everything I see, but at the very least, let's grab their money. Because that's a lot of freaking ghouls. They look a little freakier than they used to. Well, that one's leg came off. Yeah, they had a whole bombardment happening here. We just happened to find a side way in that was a bit safer. Stim pack. Don't mind if I do. These guys are rather irresponsible just leaving a box with stim packs just sitting out there. Oh. Looks like that's one of their guys. The ghouls got all the way up here. Stim pack. Holo tag. Brotherhood fatigues plus. Fusion cell. Attempt 2. Pack of cigarettes. We're doing good. More drugs. More ammo. Anything else stashed around here? There's something really satisfying about slowly... that feral ghoul got... completely disintegrated when I shot them. There's something really satisfying about wandering around here and, grabbing all the, just everything you can find, basically. The hoarder tendencies in Fallout games. Let's meet our new friends a bit more.
So you gonna patch me up or what?
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. Might be more humane to just take you out back and shoot you.
You're all hard, Doc.
Just quit squirming so I can get these bandages on. Sorry about the other guys.
Why are you cutting me so much slack?
I joined the Brotherhood not too long ago. They used to be like you. Wandering alone. So I know what it feels like when every single person you bump into sticks a gun in your face. Look, it may not seem like it, but Dance is a good man. He's just all soldier. Protocol is his bread and butter. And Reese? Well, let's just say he's as hard-headed as a Mr. Gutsy. But you know what? I trust both of them with my life. Because they're good people. And that's hard to come by nowadays.
Alright. I got a new little group of friends.
Think you're some kind of hotshot?
Wow, we got rude fast.
Why are you so angry with me?
I'm not angry. I'm just letting you know where you stand. You're hired help. And that's all there is to it.
If that's what you think.
Damn right it is. Now why don't you run off and see if Top needs you to do anything else?
Alright. Yeah. I can see how it stands out that she's being nice. Also, she's just sleeping now, I guess. If I wanted to snatch anything, that'd be the easy time to grab things. Hello. Personal terminal. Gladius personal terminal. Paladin Dance personal logs. Let's just go through our new friend's stuff. After several months, my squad has just crossed the border and entered the Commonwealth. We've chosen to immediately search the Boston region with the intention of finding a secure building to use as our recon headquarters. Soon after, my squad was ambushed by raiders. Knight Keen's power armor was destroyed, and we lost some of our supplies. Fortunately, we were able to repel the attack and continue our mission. We've discovered a secure building in Cambridge that appears to be a former police station. We were able to clear the building and recover a good deal of supplies and ammunition from pre-war caches inside. According to Scribe Halen, this location is structurally sound and highly defensible. I've decided to establish our headquarters here for the time being, which is presumably the building we're in right now. After Halen identified the Corvega factory in Lexington as a possible site containing valuable pre-war technology, we initiated a sweep and retrieve operation. I heard Dawes do a site survey, and he discovered it was being held by a large force of raiders. I gave the go-ahead, and we attempted a breach. As we approached, our squad was hit with gunfire. Knight Warwick was wounded, so I decided to fall back to Cambridge. During our retreat, Knight Breck stepped on a landmine. Scribe Halen attempted to treat him, but Breck succumbed to his wounds and died. Let it be noted for the record that Halen is to be commended for her efforts. It's been 2 days since our failed operation at Corvega, and I'm sad to report that Knight Warwick has died. His gunshot wounds had left him paralyzed and internally bleeding. Scribe Halen informed me that he was suffering and had less than 5% chance of recovery. I authorized her to inject him with an overdose of painkiller and to put him to rest. I'd once again like to commend Scribe Halen for her efforts in keeping Warwick alive for following my final orders without question. We sustained another casualty today at grid reference A113. This area contains the ruins of Boston International Airport and Fort Strong. The airport was almost completely abandoned, but Fort Strong turned out to be infested by super mutants. We were hoping to resupply the armory there, but Knight Sergeant Dawes was killed. This is the second location I've had to order a retreat from since we arrived, and the third member of my team to die. I recommend a complete bombardment of this location in the future. So you can see why he's being not the friendliest when we meet him. Scribe Halen has been picking up unusual energy readings on her instruments. She claims that they are on an extreme high band spectrum frequency, which makes it highly unlikely to be pre-war in origin. The readings are also highly sporadic, only appearing for a very short amount of time and in very specific locations. The decay of these signals is severe, and they seem to disappear off Halen's instruments after several hours. We don't have the equipment necessary to track these readings, so we're attempting to use triangulation to discover their point of origin. We've been attempting to contact Scabbard with the energy reading Halen has collected, but the police station's high-gain antenna was damaged by a supermutant rocket attack, and we can't transmit the data. Halen is attempting to repair the antenna, but she isn't certain that we have the parts we need at this time. I wouldn't be surprised if I get sent on a task related to that. So there's their orders from Gladius. Recon Squad Gladius' current orders are as follows. Proceed to the area designated as the Commonwealth to perform a standard long-range recon operation. Report any unusual activity using standard long-range communications to Scabbard. Extraction time undetermined. Paladin Dance. Personnel status. So that's their original size. So Dawes, Brack, and Warwick are dead at least. Dawes. Deceased. Reese? Active. Keen should be alive. Nope, Keen's dead. And Brack is dead. So we only people should be Dawes, Reese, and Halen, right? Yeah. This is straightforward enough. Just felt like I should check to see if something different shows up at all, but nope. Alright. Would not be surprised to be sent to do something related to that. Coffee pot. Ooh, hot plate. Hello? Scribe Halen's personal log.
Field Scribe Halen, personal log entry 324A. I'm starting to wonder if joining the Brotherhood of Steel was a good choice. I originally signed up seeking protection and comradeship, but I'm worried that I've traded away a bit of my humanity in the process. The Brotherhood's message of hope for the future is idealistic and noble, but their methods leave a lot to be desired. The leadership seems especially misguided. Instead of diplomacy, they wield violent confrontation to exert control. Despite all that, I've been successfully avoiding the fighting by following the career path of a field scribe. I suppose only time will tell how long I can stand the sight of spilled blood over my own moral fiber.
So she's having her regrets about joining. Hello, what's back here? Sweet, sweet ammo. Ooh, stimpaks. Absolutely. What's this thing over here? Can't aim at it while he's here? Ashtrays, cap stash. They don't seem to be stopping me, so I'll take it. Inactive distress pulser. What does that thing do? Fusion cells. That's a lot of ammo stashed around. Hello? How big is this place? Oh, yeah. This goes on for a while. This room looks like it has a workbench in it or something. Adjustable wrench, screwdriver, and magnifying glass. There's ammo. Good old ammo. Stim pack? Absolutely. Hopefully we can find a workbench nearby so I can just stash some stuff. Ammo. Rifle's gonna put me over the top, probably. A lot of drugs to find around here. I'm sure I can come back and loot anything I miss anyway. Oh. Cambridge Police Evidence Terminal. I have to unlock it. That shouldn't be hard, though. Let's quick save just because I haven't saved for a while. It's a Bethesda game. They can crash. Even if it doesn't feel like they will. Alright, so password required. Let's pick one at random. Broke. Blackness 1, alright. Pure OUD. That's 2, so no. UEP. UPSET. That's just E in common. Likeness, okay, so upset is not in it. Nothing with an E. Upset, that has an S. Upset, that has an E. Upset. Heard, vault, upset. T. Shows, upset, S. Super S. S. Agile, upset, E. Damn it. False, E. Has to have no E in it. Daily. Upset, none, broke. One in common with broke. Pulls. No. No. See, daily. What would it have in common with broke? B-R-O-K-E. Nope. What am I missing here? Sounds. No. Vault. No, that's a T. Heart. Shows. That's an S. No, like... Stout. Nothing with an S. Agile. No. Has an E. Can't have an E. False. Discs. Am I missing a word somewhere? Oh, wait. Is it letters in common in general, or does it just mean none of the letters in the same slots? Let's try daily. None. Okay. Having some trouble here. I was thinking letters in common. I think it actually means how many of those exact slots are correct. So it doesn't... So it has something in common with broke, but only one. B-R-O-K-E. Nope. B-R-O-K-E. Nope. B-R-O-K-E. B-R-O. Shows. Alright. And let's compare it with upset to make sure that... And daily, so they have nothing in common. D-A-I-L-Y. U-P-S-E-T. Nope.
Yes.
Got it. Alright. I figured it out. So it's the number of exact slots that are correct, not number of letters in common. That was my misinterpretation. Hollowbrook Sedition. Transferred to Federal Office J. Dobson. Object 1 statement of Mr. N. Fedricks. Object 1 pamphlet, your rights at work. Or you nionized today. These really are just police records, huh? Is there anything interesting here? Or is it just an opportunity to hack into something for some experience? Lockup, platinum inebriator. There may not be anything interesting here besides background. Ooh, location information, cool. Agent Mitchell, Boston Badful, mail to Sergeant Madden PL. We got location out of that at least. Oops. It's worth checking just in case we get new map spots. Reckless endangerment. Yep, hazardous materials, disposable unit. Just anxious, just really old records from before everything went to shit. Ooh, this goes down the motor pool. Wonder glue. Don't want to go too far with some of this stuff just because I'm going to run out of inventory space, but I'm looking for immediately usable stuff. Blowtorch. Blowtorch might be good. And it's too heavy. My mistake. Let's just get to that. Let's drop it real quick and we'll get to the quest stuff. Getting myself in trouble here grabbing all this stuff. Definitely need to find my way. Oops. I need to find my way back to one of those nice... workbenches so I can start stashing stuff again. I've got too much stuff on me right now. There's a prison back here. Hello. Sweet. Oh, the water caught. My mistake. I didn't think the water would weigh anything. Rataway. There we go. Definitely still stuff to rip out of these places. Alright, look for something that weighs. Ooh. That's value, not weight. Whoops. Pulsar. That seems like a. Coffee pot. Leg bones. Ladle. Pelvis bone. A few things that don't seem important. Super important. Paper. Toy rocket ship turpentine. Am I good to go for the moment? I'm good to go again. Alright, definitely need to find a workbench so I can start getting rid of this stuff. God damn. There's just stuff everywhere. You can lose your mind. Man. Alright, yeah, right. I leveled up. Hey, y'all. Alright. So, charisma. Is one of these immediately about conversation? That's the lone survivor. Attack dog. Your faithful canine companion can hold an enemy, giving you a greater chance to hit them in VATS. That's nice. He kind of already does that, but I assume that's what that would do. Animal friend. Commune with beasts. With your gun, aim at any animal below your level and gain a chance to pacify it. That's kind of cool. As the ruler everyone turns to, you are able to establish supply lines between your workshop settlements. Oh. That sounds handy, but it also sounds like something I don't really need yet. There's no chance you'll get addicted to alcohol. You're just too good at drinking. But everything down here is stuff I can't pick anyway. That's why they're silhouetted, because they're beyond the point of what I'm allowed to grab. Mysterious stranger, who is he? Why does he help? Who cares? The mysterious stranger will appear occasionally in VATS to lend a hand with deadly efficiency. You know what? That's just such a cool skill. I'm just gonna grab it immediately. Bam. We barely started the series, and I already have Mysterious Stranger around to help me out. Because he just does crazy shit. Alright. Hello, friend.
Paladin Dance.
You ready to move out?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the capital Wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
New friend. He's a bit of a show-off with his hat juggling. Alright, let's go. I'm sure he won't get me killed or anything. Can I go outside now? There we go. it wouldn't let me out. Alright. Let's just follow Mr. Power Armor around. I feel like he'll have me covered more or less. Hello, ammo. Missed those at first. I need to find myself a flashlight.
ArcJet is a short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated. We don't know much about them. Except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology. We're concerned that whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential threat. So it's our job to investigate.
You call yourself a scavenger, not even grabbing all the ammo that's just laying around. So handy. You gotta get the technology, bro. I know, pre-war technology, so on and so forth, but basic supplies, you say you're low. I just got so much ammo just stashed around here. I should not still be using this gun. I should use something that has actual bullets, like all those other guns I found. Damn. We have a lot of ammo for the 10 millimeter now. Just last episode, I was down to like my last 20 shots or something. Let's check the bus. Bobby pin. Don't worry, buddy. One day you'll adapt to the wasteland and figure out how to survive around here. Uh oh.
Who's there? Got company.
Oh, my dog's gone.
I don't think we're alone. We've got
company. I don't think we're alone. Were you paying attention? Hey, buddy. They literally called her Raider Scum. That's pretty funny. Gotta grab those basic supplies. There we go.
It might surprise you to learn that my recon team isn't the first to visit the Commonwealth. Over the last 7 years, two other teams were sent here by the Brotherhood to gather technology. The first team's mission was a huge success. They came back with crates full of pre-war artifacts and historical documents. The second wasn't so fortunate. Shortly after they arrived, we lost contact with them, and they haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost 4 good men to this godforsaken wasteland. We've been a target from the moment we arrived. But despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home, or end up missing.
I'm getting the feeling this voice actor's a fan of George Clooney. So they didn't really acknowledge it yet, but I think I lost the dog meat, because I assume Dance currently counts as my companion, even though I'm kind of following him. And there was, as a result, my current one kind of disappeared. I think the dog will just come and go as he pleases. There we go. Don't mind me, just scavenging so I can rebuild society. You'll understand.
Over there.
Oh yeah, I hear it. That's not the right button. Hello, friend. Not that guy. Who the fuck? I love you, V.A.T.S. Wow, shot the exact number of times I had to. Missed once. Ah, a little bit more. Oh! I was bleeding all over the place. Looks like I was getting ongoing radiation from the body. Probably want to do Rataway soon. So I tried looking up online how to heal individual limbs, and the search results were actually not any help. You might not be able to heal individual limbs. It might only be possible to heal the entire... Oh god. The entire character. Got him. A little bit of dog meat. Bottle caps! That dog had bottle caps. That's kind of weird. But okay. A lot of them have bottle caps, apparently. All these wild animals with sweet loot. This place looks great. They really nailed the environments this time around. I mean, they always did, but now they're able to do better.
There shouldn't be any exterior security, so we'll head in through the front.
There shouldn't be any exterior security. Then he triggers like 7 landmines. Oh, I was gonna see if I could shoot the crow out of the sky. I just wanted to see if V.A.T.S. would actually select it or not. Hello. I'm sure it's safe in there. We're just going around scavenging for pre-war technology and stuff like that. How could that ever backfire? Gear. Oh, that was a mistake. That was a mistake. I'm so sorry, everyone. Damn you, carrying capacity. I am like halfway ready to like... That's the one thing I'm always tempted to mod in these kinds of games, is just to be like, fucking a billion carrying capacity, screw it. So that thing's worth 2 circuitry, 1 copper, 2 fiberglass. Damn. What do you sort by? Sort by value? Weight. Oh, there we go. That'll help me out a lot. So, broom is heavy. Not very much stuff is actually heavy, though. So let's pick stuff to drop that's only worth like a couple things or nothing. A little bit of wood for a chessboard. Cigarette cartons are valuable. Wow, you get asbestos from coffee? Freaky. Bone has a value? I don't know how much I'll be crafting with bone. Oh, the gear's not that much, it's just some metal. Granted, I don't know how much steel I have around here.
It was corporations like this that put the last nail in the coffin for mankind. They exploited technology for their own gains, pocketing the cash and ignoring the damage they'd done.
You sure it wasn't the nukes? I think it was the nukes. Did I just get Nuka-Cola Cherry? They have flavors now? Besides Quantum?
Look at these wrecks. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with.
Good. Less security to worry about.
Negative. There's nothing good about it. Look at the evidence. There isn't a single spent ammunition casing or drop of blood in sight. These robots were assaulted by Institute synths.
It sounds like you're scared of synths.
There's a measurable difference between being frightened and being prepared. Now, let's move out.
Here we go. Is there any ammo around here? Security terminal.
This place is a mess, but I still...
What can you tell me about this place? Security concerns. From Thomas Reinhardt to all security personnel, I'd like to have your team get together and implement the new security strategy for the ArcJet complex. This is our first contract for the USSA, and I don't intend to have any security slip-ups while we're working on the XMB booster engine. I want you to double the coverage 24 hours a day and install automated countermeasures inside the facility. I'd also like you to hire a consultant to figure out a better security password system for our terminals. The automated reset timer mailed mailing our passwords out is ridiculous. Turrets? Starting now, we'll be distributing identification badges to all employees. These badges must be worn at all times. They're infused with a low-yield radioactive isotope that will prevent our internal security turrets from accidentally shooting any of our own employees. If anyone's caught near the entrance of the engine core without a badge, we are not liable for the injuries you may sustain. The turrets will go online in 1 week, so I suggest you sign up for your badge as soon as possible. I'd probably avoid working at a place that does turrets. Regardless of reason. Engine core accident. Yeah, don't work at Aperture Labs. Sam, what the hell is going on down there? How did a member of the press get all the way past security through the entire research facility and into the engine core without tripping our alarms or turrets? We have a real mess on our hands, and it's going to be your job to clean it up. I don't care how you do it, just make it all go away. If this comes back to bite us, I swear you're going to be the one that takes the fall. Protection control. Error. Protection unit apps are damaged. Choose personality mode. Subway steward, law enforcement, fire brigadier, medical responder, construction worker, medical responder. Personality parameter reset. Okay. What happens if I try to activate it? Please advise any personnel standing near charge pod to make way.
You'll see a few pieces of salvage that the Brotherhood might be interested in. After we're done here, I'll have to mark this place for sweep and retrieve.
Ooh, 6 steel. That's gotta be handy. I need to find myself a workbench so badly. Ooh, what's that? Military-grade circuit board. I'll take walking slow for a moment just to grab stuff like that. Protectron. A lot of robots around here. Oh, this place looks like it might go on for a while. Alright. So much stuff. Let's drop coffee pots for now. Oops. Turpentine has steel in it, cigar box, plunger. I'm not super concerned about wood-related objects. I feel like I can find wood everywhere. Wow, there's some actually really good stuff here. The gold watch seems really valuable. Let's get rid of teeth. There we go. I'll let some bone stuff go. I feel like maybe my specific group may not be super interested in bone construction, but I'm not sure. Dish rag. Nope. No stim packs happening in here. Cigarettes. Valuable. Worth keeping track of. Boulder. Alright.
Looks like a dead end. See if you can find a way to get that door open. I'm gonna reconnoiter the area.
I'm just fully expecting to get stormed by something around here. Lab and Alisternal. Reminder, password security. This is your annual reminder that all terminal and mainframe passwords are to be changed on a monthly basis. Failure to do so may result in automated changes, the suspension of network privileges, and or disciplinary action. Please do your best in keeping ArcJet systems secure. Automated password change? Hey, we got a password now. According to our records, your terminal password has not been changed in 3 months. For security purposes, your password will now be reset. 9YB3N. 9YB3N. Let's see if I can remember that or if we even need to. 9YB3N. So they had a stupid system where they would send out their passwords periodically, like all the time. And now it's biting them in the ass because they're all wiped out and the automated password keep tapping. Lab control terminal. Well, I have a password. Cool, it automatically typed in. Lab controls. Cannot establish connection to prototype. Lab technician and all that. Max security door controls interface. Open door. Getting inside! Alright, I assume that worked.
Nice work. Let's get moving.
Oh, hello.
I know you are out there.
All right. That's one way to justify people's fear of synths. He's coming straight towards me. I don't like that. Come on, put some holes in him. Uh-oh. Yes, the mysterious stranger. He's here. That's amazing. He just freaking shows up. That's fantastic. Shock baton. Doing a quick once over the area. Fusion cells. They were armed with Institute pistols.
Shh. Not getting past me.
Oh, he's under attack again.
Detected.
We may have a problem here.
He is more.
Multiple synth targets. Take them down.
He is more equipped to fight them than I am at the moment. This guy's right up in his face. Let that head shot. Yeah, let the head whip around. 50% my ass. Hey, buddy. Oh, he's down. Cool. Where's the next one? Here we are. Right over here. Oh, you got him. So much for sneaking up on him, huh? He's effective. Is he even hurt? Workbench? Oh, Trent, store all junk. There we go. That actually did not help me out that much. Hang on a second. Let's get rid of some of our excessive weapons. Most of them. Oops. Got too much crap on my character right now. Way too much crap on my character. Revolver rifle, what? 45, 308, 38, three different ammos. Don't plan on a lot of melee right now. Pipe pistol, pipe auto pistol, lower damage, don't really want lower damage. 45 caliber weapon. Here's the pipe pistol that's more effective. Get rid of our 10 millimeters. There we go. Just get rid of a whole bunch of this stuff that might be usable for the purposes of, some of this might be useful for scavenging purposes, and I might compare it later to see if it might be even be an upgrade in some way. But damn, there's too much of it in my inventory. There we go. So much better. Alright. Now I can go back to grabbing whatever I want. An armor workbench. Alright. Take a look around. Hello. That rifle's probably good. Wooden spoon. Grab it all! Tesla arc. Ooh. I'll grab those. Pack of cigarettes. There was someone shooting over. Ooh!
Loctite.
Damn it. Nuka-Cola bottle.
Security's too good.
Wow, there's suddenly some really good security around here. Can I level up yet? I cannot. So that's not going to be happening. Chemistry station. You can do a lot around here, apparently. Large toolbox. I can open this one. Nope. Here we go.
Yes.
Gimme, 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 gimme. So nice to have inventory space now that I found a usable station. If I'm going to be able to stash stuff in random workbenches, though, like that, I guess the question is, do I have access to everything there? Oops. Not what I was going for. Exit. No. How do I... There we go. It was playing out the whole animation. Transfer. There's stuff in here that I had before, right? I wasn't carrying all that just now, was I? Wooden block. IND. Yeah, I think there's more here than I was just carrying. I think that these go between all of your different spots, but I'm not sure. Oh well, I'll remember this location. If I need my stuff again, I'll just come back to the specific bench. But I think it might share them all as like one stash. I can confirm that after this episode.
Compromised most of the facility.
Even if they don't store that way, if I just find really precise locations to store things, I can just come back to them later. Between episodes and fast travel back and forth. Stealth boy. Those are just around, huh? My friend sure likes to charge ahead. Whoa, I'm on the wrong floor right now. Hang on.
Target eliminated.
Ooh, hello. Energy and weapons permanently increase, inflict 5% critical damage. Awesome. Tesla Science Magazine. CO's terminal. Maybe I can disable the turrets. Lots of shots. Mars shot project notes. After 6 months, the United States Space Administration finally approved ArcJet as the contractor for the Mars shot projector's propulsion and communication systems. Having my team start working on the XMB booster before we secured the contract was a gamble, but it looks like it's going to pay off big. We have a lot of details to hash out with the agency, and we have a lot of work ahead of us, but I think this contract will finally put ArcJet on the map. So we're talking about the project that we're here to retrieve, actually, so this is relatively relevant information. I was fortunate to be able to add Dr. Rory McClellan to the XMB booster team today. There are a few people who can match Dr. McClellan's aptitude with nuclear propulsion systems, so this truly was a coup. It cost the company a heck of a lot of money to hire him away from his military contracting job, but I'm sure it will be well worth every dollar. We've promised the USSA that the booster would be ready for at least a year before their July 2078 launch date. With Dr. McClellan at the helm, we should be able to meet the deadline with time to spare. As the holiday season approaches, it's time to take a step back and look at everything that's happened to ArcJet Systems this year. 5 months ago, the company was struggling to make ends meet. Now, the XMB booster and deep range transmitter projects are in full swing. ArcJet appears to have received a second chance. Thanks to Dr. McClellan, we're on schedule and under budget. The USSA is thrilled with our progress and already talking to me about future contracts after we deliver. I don't think it's possible to be ending the year on a better note. And then tragedy struck and everyone died or something. well, the end of the world. Dr. McClellan informed me that we have a problem with the XMB booster. The OSSA is demanding that the engine can't exceed their strict weight allowance, but thanks to uranium refinement system, we're a few hundred tons over. That's a lot of tons. We're now 1 month behind schedule, and I'm frankly starting to panic. Dr. McClellan assures me he'll find a solution soon, but that isn't helping me get to sleep at night. The USSA started their public relations campaign on the Mars Shot project, and ArcJet Systems is finding itself caught right in the middle. In the last week, I think I've fielded 15 separate interviews with everyone asking the same questions over and over again. They all want to know when we're delivering the XMB booster so they can take their pretty pictures of the USSA test firing it for the first time. and all I can do is keep smiling and lying through my teeth that the XMB will be delivered when it's ready. I hope Dr. McClellan solves our weight problem soon, or we're never going to have a contract from the USSA ever again. I can't believe it, but Dr. McClellan's team finally solved the XMB's weight problem. Now all we need to do is finish tightening a few screws and hoist this thing into the engine core. If we're lucky, we'll be able to test fire the booster right after the new year. It's funny how things seem so bleak and chaotic during the year, but it all comes together for us just in time for the holidays. We've scheduled a photo opportunity tomorrow for the XMB booster's first test firing in the engine core. We're going to stick them all down in the control room and let them shoot their pictures through a thermoglass window after Dr. McClellan gives a short explanation of how the booster works. The engine pulls out a hell of a lot of thrust, so it should be a spectacular show. Is everyone gonna die? I feel like everyone's gonna get blown up. It's been 2 weeks since the accident before the XMB booster's test firing event. Somehow, a photographer managed to wander past security and into the engine room a few hours early. Dr. McClellan was running a quick test of the booster, letting it run for only a few seconds to make sure it was ready for the demonstration, and burned the photographer to ash. Thank God no one else saw what happened. I'm having Brent take care of the remains. After all, that's why I hired him. Before this accident goes public, then we'll be shut down, and I may as well put a for sale sign out in front. So that was what we heard about in the security terminal earlier. All of the unrest overseas is making the USSA nervous about proceeding with the Mars Shot project. They're telling me They're telling me they may have to delay a year or more, depending on what happens. If that's true, we'll just have to make do with the proceeds from the Deep Range Transmitters contract we've already completed. I'm trying to keep everyone's spirits up around here, but it's getting harder and harder with the world falling apart around us. Hopefully, our government will work things out and we can all get back to work. Optimistic? They're gone. Well, I was hoping for a way to shut off the turrets, but it looks like he figured that out with his big guns. That's fine, he can do what he wants. Gold Watch! Gold Watch is useful. Yeah, he's armored. I'm not even armored, he should take out turrets, frankly. Is there a side path around here? Provides support for Paladin Dance. You're right, I did do that. Good job, me. Repair Department Terminal. What does this thing do? Alright, dead. Zero. D-E-A-D.
Nice.
Oh, cool. Nailed it on accident. Repair order. Installed new terminal in Reinhardt's office. He's depending some serious security on for now on that we've got on the Mars Shot contract. I'm not sure if he's being paranoid or if we got a real reason to worry. I'll set him up with the best we got for now. This is always cool how you can get an environmental story. Like, we can get so much here there be dragons. We can get so much story about this location that you'd otherwise not notice if you just walked in and grabbed the objective and be like, oh, there's a device here. Bye. All these security concerns and their ongoing society they had here. Okay, now I'm convinced Reinhardt's paranoid. He's having me put an automated security turret in the main hallway outside the office. You'd think we were working for the military instead of just the United States Space Administration. Got McClellan's constantly bugging me that the mainframe keeps running out of space. I ordered some more storage from our supplier, but we're rapidly running out of room down here for any more consoles. I might have to talk Reinhardt into letting us spill into the office sections. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. That's the same one again. Whoops. Brent came down and had me pull all of the video surveillance records from the mainframe of the last month. I asked him if he wanted me to just make him backups, but he grunted like he always does and demanded the originals. I have no idea what he's doing with them, and I don't want to know. As long as I keep getting a paycheck, I could care less. And his apathy led to the end of the world. No, obviously not, but you know. Anything in here, really? Alarm clock, that's probably like springs and circuits and all that. Ah, he messed up those turrets, huh? Alright, he was busy. Just gonna grab all that circuitry for our future, our base. I could probably make turrets out of that stuff. I want to make a lot of turrets to keep our area safe from raiders. Scissors, I'm running with them now. Whee! Cigarettes. That's not a safe. Everything has that weird old look to it, where it's all bulky and stuff, so even a water cooler looks like a safe to me in this game. This place is huge, by the way. Desktop picture frame. Your memories are now my building supplies. Take that. But yeah, if that one overdue book, it's been overdue for 200 years, probably. If those workstations are not magically connected through video game logic, I can always come back for that stuff pretty easily. A box of bobby pins. That's great news for me. I'm gonna be the richest fucking scavenger. It's gonna totally make up for the fact that I'm not any good at, just gonna grab this fucking sink full of hands. What's wrong with these people? I'm gonna have so much loot and equipment that's gonna make up for the fact that I'm not particularly good at actually defending myself. Aluminum canister. Ooh, ammo. So much ammo. I think I am getting into the territory of spending it, finding more faster than I can spend it. Which is mostly a good place to be. Alright. One of those periodic quick saves. Can I go past here? Made it. May not have actually found me much, though. What's in here? Hello. A few more drugs here and there. Some glass. I sometimes highlight something over here. Oh, there it is. I thought I was able to loot the body or something. Nuka-Cola machine. Nuka-Cola. I'll take it. He's down there, so I didn't really find a shortcut necessarily. I mean, I didn't find a secret. Oh, geez. Screwdriver. TV dinner tray. Cigarettes. Finding a lot of valuable cigarette packs. Receptionist terminal. This is the receptionist? Oh yeah, there's the front office where we started. Telephone. A safe? I can open safes. Oops. Getting a little aggressive with those. Oh. Careful. Yeah.
Sweet.
Awesome. More ammo. Why do these people keep storing safes spoons in their safes. Just a weird approach, I think. Alright, another terminal. Should be easy to unlock. Slate. Likeness 1. SLATE. Yeah, that's 1. 0. Alright, so... SLATE. No, I need 1. SLATE, that's 2. SLATE, that's 1. TESTS, 0. Damn it. SLATE, that's 2. SL, that's 2. SLATE, that's 0. That's 1. TESTS, that's 0. No. SLATE, that's 1. TESTS, CLIMB. Fuck. Having some trouble here. Alright. We got kicked out of the receptionist place of all time. Oh. Reset in 10 seconds, not that big of a deal. Alright, try this again. Brute. 0. B-R-U-T-E. Alright. Nope. B-R-U-T-E. V-A- Nope. Vault, no. Vault, no. V-A-U- No. V-A-U-L-T. B-R-U-T-E. Shit. Clubs. V-A-U-L-T, B-R-U, damn it. B-R-U-T, nope. B-R-U-T-E, good. Vault, V-A-U-L-T. And then steps, S-T-E-P-S, damn it. These are actually kind of tough. Not really tough, it's just... There's a lot to them. B-R-U-T, nope. B-R-U-T-E, V... A-U-L-T S-T-E-P-S. It fits everything.
I'm through.
Got it. Oh, you can just unlock the floor safe, just like that. As requested, I've had a floor safe installed in the front office area. This should allow you to pay for any incoming deliveries or restore valuables until they can be transferred to a more secure location. Let me know if you have any issues with the safe or the locking mechanism. I guess it wasn't necessarily a way to open the safe, but, you know, it already happened anyway. Reception desk, all reception area employees. I realize that our announcement regarding the Mars shot project has caused quite a lot of excitement with the national media. If any members of the press are requesting statements or interviews, please direct them to our public relations department. Do not attempt to answer any questions or give any information regarding any project unless pre-authorization has been approved. Alright. I'm letting this episode run a little long because I know that we spent a lot of time on computers and stuff like that, but I like to satisfy my curiosity around here. Gold-plated flip lighter. Gold should be good for circuitry and stuff like that, if we follow that logic set. Your country needs you. Enlist. Alright, buddy, you're down here. Quick save because of all that stuff I just did.
Engine cores ahead. Should be our final stop.
I'll properly memorize the actual hotkey for that at some point. Are you gonna open up? Oh, it's one of these. Always catches me off guard a little bit when we're in teleportation mode. Need to get me that flashlight you got, buddy. Can I just loot that from him? Aw, can't steal from your companion.
Looks like the power's out in this section.
So is that hallway, as it turns out. Ooh, connecting rod. Tube flange. There it is. That's the technology we've been reading about all episode.
Scribes would have a field day in here.
The thruster. Or the booster. I forgot which one they were calling it.
The transmitter should be in the control room at the top of the core. But it looks like the elevators are dead. We'll have to keep heading down for now and find a way to get the facility's power back online. There has to be a power backup system somewhere. Scout the maintenance area off of the main chamber. I'll remain here and watch our backs.
There's a cool sight. Alright, I think we're gonna stop it here, guys. Thanks for watching, like always. I'll see you next time. And next episode, we're gonna try to figure out how to get this cool facility back online. And maybe Dance will loosen up at some point.